With DoubtNit, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry, and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question, and get instant video solution. Download DoubtNit app today.
Hello students, the question is, which of the following orders regarding relative stability of free radicals is correct? Okay, so we need to tell out of all these four orders, which one is the correct order for the stability of free radicals, right? So let's see, what are radicals? Radicals are basically nothing, but they are the species which carry one unpaired electron like this, right? So these are radicals. So this is your methyl radical. Methyl radical. Okay, where? So now let's see. So we know that it can be our radicals can be tertiary, secondary, primary. So let's see the example of a tertiary radical. So what is a tertiary radical? Tertiary radical is a radical where a carbon which carry this radical is directly attached to three carbons. Okay. So it is directly attached to three carbons. So now here let's draw this H like this. H. Okay. So now what happens is, in these radicals, this is a tertiary radical. Why? Because this carbon which is carrying an unpaired electron, that is a radical, it is directly attached to three carbon atoms. Now what happens here? Now here, homolytic cleavage takes place. Homolytic fission of the bond takes place. Homolytic fission means, that means the bond is going to break like this. That means a bond which is carrying two electrons, right? So it will, the one electron will go towards A atom, one electron will go towards the other atom. So we will get A dot plus B, A radical plus B radical, right? Similarly, you will get this, alright? So you will get H radical and this carbon will get a radical and then this radical and then this radical will form a bond. Will form a what? Bond. So you will get this structure, CH3. CH3 is there. You will get a double bond with this CH2 and a H radical will be there. H radical will be there. Okay. Now, so now this will be the structure. And what is this method known as? This is known as hyperconjugation. This is known as hyperconjugation. Hyperconjugation. Alright. Okay. So thus this carbon from which this homolytic fission took place and led to the formation of this stable compound. This is known as alpha carbon. This is known as what? Alpha, let's write here. This is known as alpha carbon. Okay, this carbon is also an alpha carbon. This carbon is also an alpha carbon. Okay, why? Because they are alpha carbons because they are directly attached to the carbon which is carrying the radical. Right. Now, similarly, now the hydrogens which are present on these alpha carbons, the hydrogens which are present on these alpha carbons, they will be known as what? Alpha hydrogens. And we know that in hyperconjugation, more the number of alpha hydrogens is, more will be the hyperconjugating structures. More the number of alpha hydrogens in the structure, more will be the hyperconjugating structures and thus more is the stability. More is the stability. It's just like we used to do in the carbocations, right? Similarly, carbocations, same thing used to happen, right? But now forget about carbocations. But here, this H, this is leading to homolytic fission and thus leading to the formation of the stable compound. Now you can see this carbon is not having any radical. Now this is stable compound, right? So similarly, now this is the rule of hyperconjugation. I mean, this is hyperconjugation. It says that more the number of alpha hydrogens are, more will be the hyperconjugating structures and thus your more will be the stability of that compound. So thus, how many hyperconjugate? So similarly, these kind of structures more will be formed here in this tertiary. This is what? This is our tertiary. Right, this is a tertiary radical. This is a tertiary free radical. Now, if you see, how many alpha hydrogens are there? 3, 3 and 3. Right, 2 are here and 1 is here. And 3, 3 are here. So, total 9 alpha hydrogens. 9 alpha hydrogens means total 9 hyperconjugating structures will be there in the tertiary radical. Alright, now let's see an example of secondary and primary. So now if you see the example of secondary radicals, what is secondary radical will be like this. It will be like this. That means a carbon having, let's say CH3. a carbon which is having a radical, it is attached to two carbons directly, CH3. Okay, let's again write hydrogens like this, CH2. Okay, so now 1, 2 and one more hydrogen will be there. So let's write like this, hydrogen. Okay, so now what will happen? Again, the homolytic fission will take place. This will get one electron and this carbon will get one electron, and again this carbon will become a radical. So this unpaired electron will lead to the formation of a bond, right? So what you will get this CH3 C double bond CH2, and H radical will go out and a hydrogen here which was already present, right? So similarly, right, so these many so in this way many hyperconjugating structures can form, and how many can form? The number hyperconjugating structures will be equal to the number of alpha hydrogens. So this is an alpha carbon, this is an alpha carbon, this is a hydrogen, this is not alpha. So the hydrogens which are attached to the alpha carbon, they are alpha hydrogens. So it has 3 and 3 here, so total 6 alpha hydrogens are here. 6 alpha hydrogen means it is going to form the 6 hyperconjugating structures. Okay, this was a secondary radical. Now similarly, let's see the example of primary radical. So here let's say this is our CH2 C radical like this. Okay, now again homolytic fission will take place here as well. This radical will form a bond with this radical, right? Two electrons can form one bond, right? So this radical which will come on this carbon and this radical will lead to the formation of a bond, and you will get this CH2 double bond. Let's complete the valency CHH and you'll get here CH2. So you'll get this. So here this was a primary radical. Why? Because this carbon carrying having a radical on it is directly attached to one carbon atom. So this is primary. And how many alpha hydrogens are there? This is the alpha carbon. So this is only alpha carbon present, because only one carbon is attached. So the hydrogens present on it are 3. So 3 alpha hydrogens are there. So thus it can form how many alphas? It can form 3 hyperconjugating structures. So as I told you earlier, the more the number of alpha hydrogens, the more will be the number of hyperconjugating structures, and thus more will be the stability. So thus this compound can form 3 hyperconjugating structures like this. Alright, similarly this secondary can form 6 hyperconjugating structures. The tertiary can form 9 hyperconjugating structures. So tertiary had how many? It had 9 hyperconjugating structures. Secondary had how many? It had 6 hyperconjugating structures, and the primary had 3 hyperconjugating structures. So thus the stability will be what? The more the hyperconjugating structures, the more will be the stability. So tertiary radical is more stable than secondary and then primary. So this is the stability order of radicals. Alright. So thus your answer is option B. Okay. So your option B is the answer, where tertiary is more stable than secondary and then primary. Alright. And the rest are incorrect. So your correct answer is B. I hope you understood. Thank you so much.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level. Trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubt and App today.